Hey, y'all. Good evening, everybody. I hope that your day has been as blessed as mine have, and it has been an amazing day. History has been made, and we are all just in awe and basking in the glory of knowing that change has happened, but we know that God is still in control, and we love and we love what God is doing for each and every one of us. So let's do this. I am going to go ahead and pray, and we're going to get into this and go right into what God has to say. Y'all forgive me. I'm not at home. Again, out of my element, but that's all right. I am here playing double duty. I'm doing daddy and preacher, so that's all right. Daddy's side, the son is in the other room having basketball practice, and I found a spot to steal away and be able to still do Bible study. So look at God, how he works out everything. Just before we pray, let me go ahead and do like I always do. I'm going to ask you to share this broadcast, share, start a watch party, see the hearts, likes, all that good stuff to flowing. We want to be about our Father's business, and sharing this message and spreading the good news like he would have us to do. So please share and start a watch party, invite others to come and be with us on tonight. Let us pray. Eternal God, our Father, how we thank you for this another day that you've blessed us with. God, we thank you, first of all, what our eyes have seen, our ears have heard, and most of all, what our hearts have felt thus far in what you've done for us. For this country on today. Now, God, we pray that you would bless each and every one of us, that you would forgive us for our unforgiven sins, that you would consecrate our hearts and our minds, God, that we can receive a word from you. Now, God, we invite your spirit to fall fresh upon us. Father, I pray a special blessing over every household that's watching. God, that you be in the midst, that you grant them the desires of their hearts, if it be your will. Now, God, bless this message, bless this word. Father, let it be nourishment of good soul food that we can apply to our everyday living, that we may have a closer walk with you. It's in the mighty, precious name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Amen. Listen, today has been a great historical day, and I have been watching, my timelines on social media and everything else has been filled with pink and green and pearls and chucks and photos of they've been calling him Brother Biden. All of these things have been just an exciting thing to witness, and we are hoping and trusting, not that we put in trust in any one of them. Our hope and trust still lies within our Savior, but we know that God can work through them and allow us to get to where we need to be. So what we witness, and it's amazing, and it's interesting, is we witness basically another changing of the guard, if you will, another changing of office, another change that took place that is something that happens in a consistent time in our life, is when we get to a point to where change must happen, you know, and it's interesting that what was placed on my heart and what I see is that of simply a changing of the guard. It's a changing of who's in power. It's a change of it shows new directions. It shows new things that are to come. It shows an opportunity to progress. It shows another chance of putting something else in place to be able to move forward. And I found that interesting for the simple fact that how often do we think about that in our own lives? How often do we think about the changing of the guard? How often do we think about the changes that are necessary in our own lives in order for us to progress, to have a closer walk with God? How often do we think about a changing of the guard, if you will, when it comes to how we think? The things that we do, the things that we say, oftentimes we allow the wrong guard to be in place. We allow the wrong person to be in charge. Who is that that I'm talking about? I'm simply talking about the devil himself. Sometimes we have to have a changing of the guard or a changing of the mindset, if you will, to let the Lord lead us to where he's trying to go. We witnessed how Biden and the family and everybody else came in, and they came in a manner of great dignity, and they came in a matter of a sense of pride of knowing that they were getting ready to embark upon some things that would help this country. And their hope and their prayer is that whatever they do is something that is for the better. Now, I couldn't help but to imagine the fact of how we walk into places sometimes, how we carry ourselves sometimes, how we move in different facets of life and what we're doing. I can't help but to imagine and think, what if we carried ourselves and walked in the dignitary manner that God would have us to do? I've seen so many people walking around with their heads down, walking around with attitudes, walking around with saddened hearts, walking around with frowns on their face. Why? Because they hadn't truly embraced the fact that we serve a God who's willing and able to do any and everything that we ask. We serve a God who's willing to put a smile on our face, to put joy in our heart. But yet and still, sometimes we allow the negative aspect of it to grasp us and hold us so tight that we forget about the fact of who's really in charge. We hold on to those things of old. We hold on to those negative things, and we try our best to try to get out of those situations. But rather than them getting better, just like the story says, most times it's going to grow worse. So we have to find somewhere in our heart and our mind to change the guard, to change the way of thinking, to change our attitude and our mindset to say, hey, listen, if God be for me, he's more than the world. Like, listen, we have to have the mindset of knowing that if I put my hope and trust in God, I'm going to be good. As a matter of fact, the scripture that came to my mind, that came to my heart, was that over in the 37th number of Psalm, verse 23, where it says, the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, and he delighteth in his way. Listen, the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. Look at what he's saying right there. All he's saying is, we have to turn everything over to God. We have to allow him to be our guide. We have to allow him to be a lamp unto our feet. We have to allow him to take us down the straight and narrow road that he wants us to go down in order to be successful. We have to go through these things, and if we want to survive. And God wants us to all survive. He wants us to have a sense of peace, a sense of understanding, a sense of patience. He wants us to have all of these things in order to make it. But sometimes we get caught up in what we're seeing rather than what God said. Sometimes we get caught up in what we're seeing rather than what God said. Listen, this whole 37 number of Psalm, man, I was reading it earlier and I was going through, and some of the things that jumped out to me, we probably all experienced it. And I'll just be honest and I'll just be real. We probably all experienced it over the last 4 years. I'm just saying. Look how it starts out. It says, fret not thyself, verse 1. Fret not thyself because of evildoers. Now, I understand. I understand that when people do you wrong, when people are acting in a manner that doesn't have your best interest at heart, when people are talking about you, when people are dragging your name through the mud, when people are stepping over you or pushing you out the way or undercutting you or whatever, cutthroat, whatever you want to call it, when the people of this world are doing those things to you, it's difficult. It is difficult to overlook those things. Why? First of all, our flesh is weak. And the first thing that we typically comes to us that says when these things happen are, you're going to give them a piece of your mind. You probably going to tell them some words that ain't godly. You probably going to try to do some things to hurt them. It depends on what it is. But let's be honest. We all have had these thoughts. We all have been in these places to where when someone has done us wrong, when someone has caused us some kind of hurt, some kind of pain, we get so upset about the fact of trying to figure out first, why did they do it? Then trying to figure out what can I do to combat whatever it is that they're doing. But when we look at the scripture, when we dive into the word, it says, fret not thyself because of evildoers. Listen, let's just take inventory. Let's just look back real fast. And I promise I won't be long, but just look back over the last 4 years. We've all heard malicious things, evil things, all of these things that have transpired, all of the things that put us in hard places, all of these things that have that we thought we would never get out of. And I just want you to stop and think, but it didn't even have to be the last 4 years. It could be last week. It could be any other time that you've been in a predicament, been in a situation to where you was wondering how it is that you're going to get out because somebody has put you in a bad spot. Now take that inventory. Now think about it. And ask yourself this question. Am I okay? Am I still breathing? Am I still living my daily life day to day? Is everything still? Am I still being provided for by God? Have I still had food on my table, a roof over my head, clothing on my back? Have I still had all of these things? If so, then guess what? The Bible says, fret not thyself of evildoers. He's reminding us right there. Don't worry about all of that stuff. I got you covered. I got you covered. I'm right here with you. It doesn't matter what happens. It doesn't matter what darts they throw. They will not prosper. It doesn't matter what stones they throw. It will not make it to you. It will not harm you. All of these things. He says, fret not thyself of evildoers, for they all shall be cut down. But then he goes on to encourage those that do believe by saying the steps of a good man. In there, he even says, trust in the Lord and do good. He's in there saying, for yet a little while, the wicked shall be, but yea, do you diligently consider that you have a place with me. He's already laid it all out. But we have to have, again, the mindset of knowing that, am I going to let the devil continue to lead? Am I going to let the devil continue to grab me? Am I going to let the devil continue to try to mess me up? The devil is busy. The devil comes in many shape, forms, and fashions. Let me share that with you. The devil comes in many shape, forms, or fashion because he wants to seek and destroy. He's going to come in ways that you like. He's going to present himself in some of the things that you enjoy doing. He's going to present himself in some things at your job, at your church, at your home, whatever. He will present himself any way that he possibly can to mess you up and get you to turn away from God. That's what he does. That's his desire. And that's what he will continue to do. But if we take the act of this historical day and we flip it and consider it in our relationship with God, are we willing to allow him to lead us? Are we willing to allow God to take front and center? Are we willing to allow God to take us by the hand and lead us where he wants us to go? Are we willing to accept the fact and take the oath, which is simply saying, Lord, I trust and believe in you. I believe that you came, you died, and you rose again. Lord, are you willing to take that oath and have a close relationship with God. Listen, if you're willing to take that oath, let me share something with you. When you get in those places, when you get in those predicaments, yeah, we all have a relationship with Christ, but every now and again, it's all right to take that oath again and say, Lord, I want to be more like you. I want to walk with you. I want to talk with you. God, here I am. Send me. It's all right to every now and again reinvest yourself and say, listen, Lord, I've done some things that I should not have done. I've strayed away from way too long, but yet now, God, I need to be closer. I need a closer relationship with you. I'm trying to draw near unto you, God. Every now and again, it's okay to do that and say, listen, I want to recommit myself into what you want me to do. And in this historical event that took place, when I watched them take the oaths and raise their hands, I couldn't help but see a different visual of raising our hands and lifting them up to God and praising him and telling him, Lord, whatever your desire is, please do it. Lord, just have thine own way. That's where our trust needs to lie. That's where our trust should be. That's where we should be diving in and having our faith is in God. But he says, hey, listen, trust in me, follow me, I'm going to order your steps, and if your steps are good, I got you covered. But then it's understandable that we're going to fall. It's understandable that we gonna fall short. It's understandable. Why? Because we are not perfect. There was but one perfect person, and we are not him. So we will fall short. We will miss the mark. We will not make it to certain places on time that God wants us to go. But as long as we are still fighting and striving to get there, guess what? You will make it, but we gonna fall short. But even the next verse says, though he fall, he shall not be utterly cast down, which means he is going to reach down and pick us up and still lift us to where we need to go. Even in our shortcomings, even in our downfalls, he is going to come and pick us up and help us along the way. That's a mighty good commitment. That's a mighty good oath. That's a mighty good oath that the Lord has given to us, and a decree to him to tell us that I love you. You're my child. You've accepted me. Now let me do for you. But we have to open our hearts. We have to change the guard and get rid of the attitudes, get rid of the negativities, and allow the love and the peace of God to come into our hearts and our minds. There's a battle that many of us have been having in our own hearts, in our own minds, simply by the things that we've seen, simply by what we've been witnessing, simply by what has transpired. You hear many people say, oh, I'm going to do this. Oh, I'm going to do that. I'm going to go out there and hurt somebody. Oh, I'm going to do. When in fact is, God is a God of love. He's a God of peace. He's a God of understanding. And the problem is when we try to intervene, when we try to intervene and we try to fight the battle ourselves, when we can turn it over to God himself and let him fix it, that's when faith comes in. That's when your active faith comes in to say, hey, while I see that there is so much hatred in the world, I'm going to turn it over to God. I'm going to still try to help do my part. I'm going to still speak up and say what's not right. But what I'm first going to do is acknowledge God. Because if I don't acknowledge him, none of the stuff that I do is going to matter anyway. So therefore, I have to acknowledge him and then have the discernment to know when to speak up and when to shut up. My God. Lord, thank you for that one. I have to have the discernment. I'm going to say that one again. You have to have the discernment to know when to speak up and when to shut up. You speak up when there's an opportunity for you to help somebody as they travel alone. You shut up when you realize that, God, this is something totally for you to fix. You shut up when you realize that I can't do nothing with this, but God has to have his hand on it. There are times when we have to totally turn it over to him and take your hands off of it. And when you do that, you'll find yourself in a greater sense of peace, joy, love, and happiness. You'll find yourself being able to walk around and smile, and folk will know what's going on, but yet and still you can tell them why you are smiling. It's because you've turned it over to God, and you're going to allow him to work it out. Listen, I that's all I have on tonight. I just want us to know that the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. The steps of a good person are ordered by the Lord. The step of those who following God are ordered by God, by the Lord himself. Don't worry about all the other stuff. Don't worry about the wickedness. Don't worry about the darts. Don't worry about the bowls. Don't worry about all of these things that are being shot at you and tossed at you. Now, I'm not going to say it's going to be easy, because again, we're human. We're human. You're going to want to say something. You're going to want to do something. But make sure before you do anything, make sure that you speak to the Lord about it. And then have the discernment again to listen and go where he wants you to go. That's it. You have to, in your own heart, have a changing of the guard. You have to, in your own heart, have a changing of the guard to say, listen, I want to put God first and all the other stuff got to leave. I want to put God first and let him be up front and all the other things have to leave. I want to put God first. That is my changing of the guard within me, is to put God first. And then all these other things, God, whatever you want to do with it, you can do with it. But as long as you are first, as long as I'm following you, as long as I'm trusting you, all will be well. Listen, that's it. I'm sorry. That's all I got on tonight. Just know that God is still in control. He's still leading us where he wants us to go. As long as you're trusting in him, as long as you are following him, don't worry about all the other stuff. Trust God. And when you trust God, everything else is going to be all right. Amen. Let us pray. And then I got a couple of quick announcements after that. Eternal God, our Father, how we thank you for what you've done in our hearts and our minds. Oh God, we thank you for how you continue to bless us day after day. God, we thank you for how you've kept us thus far. Father, even though we've seen so much, even though we've endured so much, even though we've had to battle so many things, God, we trust and know and believe, God, that as long as we follow you, as long as we accept you, as long as we listen to you, God, you are going to lead us where you want us to go. But then, Father, give us the ability and the strength to be able to accept the places that you're trying to take us. It may be somewhere we may like. It may be someplace that we don't want to go. But in any way, Father, we pray that you bless our hearts and our minds to be able to trust and understand that wherever you lead, God, is where we'll follow. But then, God, change our hearts and our minds to be able to follow you first and understand that you are first and not the last. You are the first one we should go to and not the last. For we know that you are Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. But we also know that first we should acknowledge you. God, thank you for what you've done. Bless everyone that's watching. Father, be a blessing in their homes. Bless them. Keep them is my prayer. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Listen, just a couple of quick announcements. Please, please, ma'ams and sirs, we are going back to in-person service on Sunday. This Sunday, we will be live and in person on this Sunday. So we hope to see some of your smiling eyes there. We can only see your eyes because you're required to wear a mask. So we hope that you would be there. Sister Smith, are you still on here? If you are on here, please say yes. But we are hoping and praying for many of you to, okay, I just see you right there. Hoping and praying that many of you would come and share with us. Sister Smith, if you don't mind helping me with, or Sister Johnson, one of y'all helping with getting the ushers and letting them know, hey, we are back live to be there. We will be checking temperatures at the door. That is requirement, and wearing a mask is a requirement. So make sure that you have a mask. We will ask you to sign in when you get there just so we can keep track. But we are opening back up. The ushers are still well aware of how we're seating people. So we look forward to having a wonderful in-person service on this Sunday. But also for all members, immediately following the morning worship service, Pastor McNeely has called a church business meeting. We will have that immediately for all members, immediately following morning worship service, so we won't have to travel back and forth. We can just go have it all at that time. So we hope that you would be present. We've been announcing this for the last couple of weeks now, so make sure that you are present so that you can hear and receive what Pastor McNeely has to share with us on Sunday. Let us continue to be in prayer for all those that are sick and shut in. As we always do, we continue to pray for all of our mothers. Also, let us be in prayer again for Brother DeMarco King and his family. His wife's father passed away on this week. And I believe it was today. He reached out to me. I'd have to go back through, but I believe his wife's father passed away on today. So we definitely want to keep them lifted in prayer. And all those others who are bereaved, sick and shut in, or going through this COVID, whatever the case may be, we lift each and every one of you up as well. All right. Thank you, Sister Smith. I see your message. That's good. That's good. I don't have anything else. But again, I hope to see all of you, all smiling faces on Sunday. I want to hear you shouting amen through your mask and all that good stuff. We hope that something was said that you could take it, apply it to your everyday living, that you may have a closer walk with Him. Amen. Good to see you, Brother Johnson, Derek Johnson. We've still been praying for you, man.